Greetings, Academia IAPSM eConnect. We, the team Guardians, present to you the fifth capsule of Public Health Update series for the month of November 2021. This capsule covers three themes. The first part will cover environment and health. The second part will cover COVID-19 updates. And third and final part will cover reports and surveys. So, without further ado, let's move on to our first part, which is environment and health.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Rachana from MMCRA Mysuru. I'm going to talk about Swachh Sarvekshan 2021. Swachh Sarvekshan 2021 is the world's largest urban sanitation survey, which was launched in 2017 as a part of Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. It is the annual survey of cleanliness, hygiene and sanitation in towns and cities across India. This survey covered 4,320 cities during 28 days and the report was released on 24th November 2021. This year, cities were ranked based on three criteria: service level progress, certification and citizens' voice. The fourth criteria, which was present in 2020, that is direct observation, was combined with service level progress criteria. Under the service level progress criteria, segregated waste collection, processing and disposal formed the major indicators, while under citizens' voice, citizens' feedback is the major indicator. Also, this year, QR codes were generated for citizens to scan the QR codes and register their feedback. Certification of cities were done based on open defecation status and garbage-free city star ranking. Major improvement in service level progress and citizens' feedback was seen in Punjab, Goa, Orissa, Telangana, Jharkhand and Madhya Pradesh as compared to northeastern states. Among 28 states, Chhattisgarh ranked highest and Meghalaya ranked lowest in cleanliness, while a major improvement was seen in Karnataka, where its rank shifted from 21st to 9th position. It is due to the improvement in the support of state to urban local bodies. A new category of awards was introduced this time, Prerak Daur Samman, to further motivate competition among states. In this, cities were categorized into Divya, Anupam, Ujjwal and Arohi based on some indicators falling under service level progress criteria.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Arunima Saini, and to begin with part 2 of this capsule, I'm going to talk about COVID-19 vaccines in children. As we know, COVID-19 vaccines have been available for adults for quite some time now. As children are vulnerable too, we are eagerly waiting for COVID-19 vaccines for them as well. Various vaccine candidates are available for pediatric age group. For November 2021 updates about vaccines, the first vaccine which is available is ZyCoV-D from Zydus Cadila Pharmaceuticals. It is world's first plasmid-based vaccine. It is available with a needle-free applicator. The needle-free applicator ensures less common side effects of the vaccine. It has been granted approval for restricted use in emergency conditions in the age group of 12 to 18 years. Another vaccine which is available is Covaxin from Bharat Biotech. It is an inactivated whole virion vaccine. By the end of November 2021, it was under consideration for approval for use in less than 18 years of age. In early December, it was approved for use in emergency conditions in the age group of 12 to 18 years. For further updates about vaccines in pipeline, please watch our December update video in the upcoming days.
I'm Dr. KMT Shoaib from BMCRA Bengaluru. I'll be continuing with the third part of the video, that is reports and surveys. I'm going to talk about SDG Urban Index. The Sustainable Development Goal Index is first worldwide study to assess where each country stands with regards to achieving the Sustainable Development Goals. Niti Aayog felt the need to monitor the progress towards the SDGs separately for urban areas. Hence, an SDG Urban Index was launched with a dedicated dashboard on 23rd November 2021. The dashboard covers 56 cities of India. One can check the progress of cities and also compare between the cities based on indicators across 17 goals on this interactive dashboard. Shimla scores the highest in front runners category, followed by Coimbatore, whereas Dhanbad scores the lowest in performer category. The reason for the same is that Shimla is in achievers category for SDG 12 and 13, and Coimbatore is in front runners category in all SDGs except SDG 2, 8 and 10. The index and dashboard will further strengthen SDG localization and institute robust SDG monitoring at city level. This transformative change is quite essential given the increasing prominence of our cities and urban areas in charting the future development of India. Coming to National Multidimensional Poverty Index. The Global MPI report is released every year in July by UNDP and OPHI. Baseline report on National MPI based on National Family Health Survey 4 data has been developed by Niti Aayog in partnership with various ministries and international publishing agencies and was released on 27th November 2021. The aim is to use it as a primary tool for monitoring progress on SDG 1 on ending poverty. The National MPI has three equally weighted dimensions, that is health, education and standard of living. The National MPI model retains the 10 indicators of Global MPI model along with addition of two indicators, which are antenatal care in health dimension and bank account in living standards dimension. Theoretically, MPI can range from 0 to 1. Higher the index, higher the poverty. MPI score of urban India is 0.04 and rural India is 0.155 with national average of 0.118. The percentage of people who are multidimensionally poor are highest in Bihar and lowest in Kerala. It shall serve the purpose such as enhanced high-level view of poverty at national level, complements monetary poverty measures, and provides valuable information to shape policy.
Hello everyone, I am Dr. Rajkumar, Community Medicine Postgraduate from Raja Muthaiah Medical College, Chidambaram. I am going to talk about National Health Account Estimates released for the year 2017-18. The NHA estimates show the government expenditure on health exhibiting an increasing trend and also a growing trust in the public healthcare system. The share of the government health expenditure in the total GDP of the country has increased from 1.5% in the year 2013-14 to 1.35% in the year 2017-18. Additionally, the share of the government health expenditure in total health expenditure has also increased over time. The share of primary healthcare in the current government health expenditure has increased from 51.1% in the year 2013-14 to 54.7% in the year 2017-18. The government's efforts to improve the public healthcare are evident with out-of-pocket expenditure as a share of total health expenditure coming down from 64.2% in the year 2013-14 to 48.8% in the year 2017-18. One of the factors attributing to this decline is the increased utilization and reduction in cost of services in the government healthcare facilities. The NHA estimates for 2017-18 clearly show that there has been an increase in the share of the government health expenditure in the total GDP of the country. Coming to National Family Health Survey 5 Phase 2 findings, it was released on November 24, 2021 by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India. It was conducted in 6.1 lakh sample households from 707 districts. It included some new focal areas like death registration, preschool education, expanded domains of child immunization, micronutrients to children, menstrual hygiene, frequency of alcohol and tobacco usage, additional components of NCDs like age for measuring hypertension and diabetes being more than or equal to 15 years of age, and 100% institutional deliveries were found in the states of Puducherry and Tamil Nadu, mainly attributing to their flagship scheme of Dr. Muthulakshmi Reddy Maternity Benefit Scheme. Full immunization drive for ages 12 to 23 months have improved substantially from 62% to 76%, with Odisha being the highest with 90% of immunization coverage. All the phase 2 states have achieved a replacement level of fertility of 2.1 except the states of Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan and Jharkhand. contraceptive prevalence rate has increased from 54% to 67% at all India level except the state of Punjab. On comparison of NFHS 4 and NFHS 5 data, the increase in full immunization coverage is observed to be expeditious in many states and union territories. It is mainly attributed to the flagship initiative of Mission Indradhanush launched by the government since 2015.
Hello everyone, myself Dr. Sanket Nandekar and I am from IMS BHU Varanasi. I am going to talk about Omicron updates. Omicron, a new variant of concern for COVID-19, spreading worldwide rapidly. Here, we will see some of the important timelines and update about the variant. Omicron, first reported from South Africa's Gauteng province on 24th of November 2021. On 26th November, WHO designated this variant as a new variant of concern. On 27th of November, Health Ministry briefed our officials like PMO about the seriousness of Omicron. And on 28th of November, Home Secretary chairs a high-level review meeting and advised states and union territories to keep strict vigil at airports and ports. On 29th of November, Health Ministry revised guidelines for international travelers coming to India from at-risk countries to mandatorily undergo post-arrival COVID-19 testing at airports. On 30th of November, Center reviewed public health preparedness with states and union territories and re-emphasized on test, track, treat and vaccinate strategy. Like all variants of COVID-19, Omicron also can cause mild to severe disease or death, in particular for the most vulnerable people, and thus prevention is key. The effectiveness of vaccine is not yet known. Still, it is better to be vaccinated than not. About RT-PCR, it continues to detect COVID-19 infection, include Omicron. And about patient management, clinical management of patient with Omicron remains unchanged. Considering its rapid increase in the number of cases, this variant can severely increase burden over healthcare system in terms of hospital admission and patient care. So, the best thing for us to do is to keep ourselves safe, get vaccinated when we can, and make sure we take steps to reduce our exposure to this virus. For further updates, do watch our December update video on our IAPSM eConnect platform in the upcoming days.
With this, we conclude the updates for the month of November 2021. Our team, The Guardians, comprises of Dr. Rachna K. Nair, Dr. S. Rajkumar, Dr. Lavanya B., Dr. Sanket Nandekar, Dr. Aronima Saini, and myself, Dr. KMD Shoaib. At this point, we would like to extend our heartfelt gratitude to our mentor, Dr. Malati M., for her valuable inputs and her constant support and motivation. We would also like to sincerely thank our advisors, Dr. Maltesh Undi, Dr. Sanjeev Kumar, Dr. Parag Chawda, for their support and for bringing us all to this platform. We would also take this opportunity to extend our sincere gratitude to our senior IAPSM office bearers. Thank you for your time and hope you all are positively enlightened with the updates. The Academia IAPSM eConnect will soon come out with the updates for the month of December 2021. Kindly subscribe to our channel, Academia IAPSM eConnect, and click on the bell icon to receive notifications. Till we meet again, stay connected and stay safe.